Associative learning is learning that lets one thing predict another thing. It tells you how to predict the future on the basis of past experience, and it imbues the world with meaning. Associative learning is a powerful example of kind of learning. Its best understood form of associative learning is classical conditioning, sometimes called Pavlovian conditioning because it was discovered by Ivan Pavlov. Pavlov was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology in 1904 for discoveries about the digestive system, which he studied in dogs. As part of his research, Pavlov measured salivation in dogs. Dogs, like people, naturally salivate as they eat and digest food. Unexpectedly, Pavlov noticed that the salivation could be triggered not only by the food in the dog's mouth, but also by other stimuli that were associated with the food, such as when they saw the empty bowls that usually contained the food, or even the researcher who usually brought the food. This occurred even when no food was present. The salivation could also occur in response to a stimulus that had nothing to do with the food, such as a simple tone, so long as the tone predicted the arrival of the food. The process by which dogs learn to associate any stimulus with the arrival of the food is called classical conditioning. So how does classical conditioning work? How do we learn that a stimulus predicts another stimulus? For classical conditioning, we need to start with an unconditioned stimulus that causes a natural bodily response. In this case, the unconditioned stimulus is the food. Then we need an unconditioned response. In this case, the unconditioned response is the salivation in the dog. The dogs have a natural unconditioned response, salivating, when they eat the unconditioned stimulus, food. Now comes the new associative learning through classical conditioning. A neutral, meaningless stimulus is presented just before the food. For example, it could be a tone. The tone then becomes the conditioned stimulus. At first, this tone does not lead to salivation. It is meaningless to the dog. But if the tone is presented multiple times just before the food is given, the dog salivates to the tone even before the food arrives. Indeed, the dog salivates to the tone by itself, having learned by classical conditioning the association between the tone and the food. This is now the conditioned response. The simple example of classical conditioning shows how experience changes the mind and brain of an organism. How to predict the future on the basis of past experience? After classical conditioning, the tone predicts the food. And it imbues the world with meaning. The tone meant nothing, and now it means something. It means food is coming. Classical conditioning can be a sophisticated and flexible form of learning. For example, if the tone no longer predicts food, the association is weakened or eliminated, what we call extinction. Conditioning allows you to learn generally so that salivation occurs to similar tones that differ somewhat from the original tone. It can also discriminate between two different tones if only one tone really predicts the food. All this sophistication makes classical conditioning a powerful form of learning that can apply to many different experiences with precision.